The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show. Tax the rich, feed the poor, tell their own old rich no more.
Welcome to Pod Talk, everybody. I'm Paul Daniels. I'm here with Jeremy Gibbs. All right, Jimmy, what's the first story tonight? First story we got to do is
introduce the producer.
That happens. It wouldn't be a good show if we didn't fuck up
Welcome
in the beginning,
to the Paul
right?
Daniels Comedy Hour.
All right, Jimmy, what do we got there, brother?
Only one I can think is the 9% of the
stimulus.
Stimulus.
9% of the stimulus is going to the American people. The rest is pork.
They're paying off all the Democrat states. You know, the ones that are all in turmoil.
They're paying off all the ones who cooperated.
Right, all the ones that burnt their cities down and now want money.
Right, and Nancy Pelosi giving them. $7 billion she put in for a rail something in her neighborhood.
Oh, a rail system in San Fran. And that's never going to get built. It's never, ever going to get built. They will not lay one fucking piece of track.
You're aware, what was the last stimulus bill was what? $2 trillion something, right?
I believe it was right about the 1.9 or whatever, yeah.
You're aware that over $1 trillion of that last stimulus bill has not been spent.
So it's just sitting
right, it's
somewhere?
Supposed to be to open the kids up in school, but they're not going to be paying that until 2023.
2023?
That's what the guy said. I can't remember who. It was a news station.
Like the second. Is that like.
They got their money in San Francisco. Immediately.
Right.
But like I said, go open up the schools for the children. It ain't. 2023 is when the money starts going.
Wow. So there's going to be parts of the country that are literally going to have their kids learning at home until 2023.
Right. Yep. Well, the Democratic states.
Yes. Oh my all God. In Democratic
like I said,
controlled
Texas,
states
Texas, Florida are two good examples, and they're not using masks, and they're separating.
Well, you gotta account for the fact that before Biden was inaugurated, the PCR test for COVID-19 was 40 cycles.
Right.
Then Biden was inaugurated, they cut that in half. So the more cycles you do, the more likely you are to find a positive result.
Exactly.
Guess what? Biden looks like the hero when in reality they just cut down how many cycles the tests are.
Right. So they're fudging the numbers.
They're fudging the numbers to make him look like the hero when 2024 comes around that he gets reelected. Assuming he has not been ruled
He's
incapacitated by the 25th Amendment.
Yeah, and Harris is president. And I don't fuck. I'm getting so fucking pissed.
Are you hearing something?
No.
No.
I'm hearing nothing, Jim.
I don't think it came on then yet. I'm trying to see if we're broadcasting.
Are you hearing it?
No, I'm hearing me record it.
So why aren't you listening to see if
I'm on TuneIn right now, looking at the radio station and trying to see if it's working?
Oh, my fucking head. Isn't this something we should have checked out before we went on the air?
We did. We got the music.
You would think so. And guess what? When you Google Armed Radio Global comes up second in the list.
What comes up first?
Armed Radio.
all right. That's what we are, Armed Radio.
Right.
You're Armed Radio Global.
No, we're not. No, we're not.
On TuneIn, we're Armed Radio.
Yes. They asked, the military asked us to stop using Armed Radio Global. So we did. Yes, because it sounded too much like Armed Forces Radio. And that's why we went to Armed. Yes.
I did not know that.
Yes. Joseph made it clear to us.
So that's why I've been using Armed Radio since the beginning. And when Joe went to the Armed Radio Global, I didn't follow it. So, no, we're doing Armed Radio.
But, and then the military asked. And they just asked.
They asked. And they haven't said anything since.
And they did, and they even said, we can't stop you from doing it.
Right.
We're just asking you as a favor. And Joseph, being a, you know, a good patriot, said, yes, we'll do that. Anything? Anyone?
Anything? Anything? Euler?
We're not broadcasting.
Oh, God, this is... It's already going to fucking shit in a handbasket. you know, I just want to take the headphones off and fucking go home.
You took it.
Thank you. Thank you. Enough! You already started to piss me off. The fuck? We were talking about the goddamn stimulus package. Can we get back to it?
But that's all I had was 9% of it went to the...
Right.
You got yours today. Tell all the people you got yours.
No.
The rest of it.
That's nobody's fucking business.
What? Not the amount of somebody's business, even though they know that.
Why am I hearing the show coming through my headphones?
All right, finally. We're broadcasting.
Thank you. That one's deserved.
See, I had to change the setting on.
All right, that's fine.
And now we're live.
All right, great.
All right.
So we're live now?
Well, no, I'm saying now we're broadcasting.
We weren't before that, though.
No.
So that whole beginning is missed.
Pretty much.
Yay.
Like I said, I get a picture of this thing.
Fuck. Oh, I want to bang my head off a wall so fucking bad right now. God damn it. Hey, Jeremy, you got anything? Anything? Please say yes.
Bueller.
That's not helping. Not at all.
We can go with Cuomo.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you, Jim. Yeah, Governor Cuomo has picked up a seventh accuser today. And de Blasio's asked him to resign. Nadler.
Schumer. And
Schumer too?
Schumer and...
I'll tell you what, right now, regardless of how guilty or innocent that man is, he will not resign and he will not be impeached.
I think he will. I think he will be impeached because when in New York, if you can get Republicans and Democrats to agree on anything, I think that it's going to happen. The pressure is just going to become too much. It's just going to be too much, and he's going to have to quit. You got fucking Democrats everywhere fucking calling on it. If he was smart, he would resign.
He would never resign because that'd be like admitting guilt. He will not resign until at least one or two of the cases go to court.
You think he's going to wait that long?
Well, he would have to, otherwise he'd be admitting guilt.
Well, you were governor for 6 years, right?
If he resigned before going to court, he's admitting guilt, and he's lost.
Well, you know what? That's a good point. That's a good point. It's almost admitting guilt. You're right.
Cuomo will not do that until he's put into a situation where he has to.
And you know what? He's got that gangster mentality anyways.
Well, yeah, he's probably got the mob's probably got him in his pocket or in their pocket.
Oh yeah. And there's his brother Fredo on CNN having to ignore the fucking 2,000 pound elephant in the room. It's fucking beautiful.
He's done nothing but be the worst for them. I don't know. They're losing fucking ratings and they still got him on.
There is no out for CNN.
What is this? Their connection to the governor?
Yeah. It is so far gone for CNN that they have to stick with their bullshit narrative to keep from sinking faster.
Yeah, there's no out for them. It's coming. The inevitable's coming. I mean,
they have to continue to play their narrative to try to save face as long as they possibly can.
Exactly. They have to go down with the ship. There's no other way out. Better to fade into obscurity than to be the punchline at every fucking party. I think I said that pretty well. Nothing? Alright, that's what I get. That's what I get. It's the luck of the draw on that one, I guess.
I was reading an article, trying to read an article on Cuomo, and I was like totally ADHD into that article. So
great, now I got two of yous. How the fuck am I supposed to do a radio show?
I'm almost done rolling.
No. That should have been applause. That should have been applause.
Okay.
I mean, thank you. Jesus Christ. I feel like I'm the only sane person in an insane fucking town.
If you're the only sane person in an insane town, that town is doomed.
Yes. I agree. 100%. So are we going to go back to Cuomo or are we just going to fucking...
Yes, let's go back to fucking Cuomo and how he's making millions of dollars off of his fucking book on how big of a fucking hero that piece of shit is. Murdering thousands.
Yep. And there's no other way to phrase that. He murdered them people. He knowingly ordered
them back into nursing homes knowing that they would be more susceptible to COVID-19.
Oh, and guess what?
And
Gretchen Whitmer?
Javits.
Yes, I was just going to say that. I swear to God, she's in deep poo-poo too.
Oh. Yes, Whitmer. Gretchen Whitmer ordered senior citizens back into nursing homes.
Yep. And it's some attorney in Michigan. He said, look, I can't do this because of HEPA laws.
I don't know what that is.
About client confidentiality, doctor-client.
Yeah.
He said, you have to get these stories to me so I can build a case against her.
Here's the difference between Whitmer and Cuomo. The numbers are out on Cuomo. Whitmer, her department will not release the numbers.
Yeah, but once they're subpoenaed, they'll have to.
That's not necessarily true. They subpoenaed the election changes and laws and results and everything else and got denied.
Then do you know what you do? Just bring up the charges. Just bring up the charges. Even if she gets away with it, she's charged. She has to go to court. She'll be placed under oath.
She's honestly, what this looks like to me is it looks like the Democrats are being allowed to screw up so the public can see just how stupid they really are.
They're horrible. You know what? I hated liberals back in the day.
Nothing pisses people off more than a fucking Democrat that says, hey, the country's going to be great if we get elected. We're going to do this. We're going to do that. And then when they get elected, everything fucking falls apart.
And it happens constantly.
You know, I don't want to wait another 3 years for it to change. I want my country back.
He would not ban fracking. Joe Biden said he would not shut down the Dakota Access Pipeline. Joe Biden said he would not shut down the pipeline for Canada. Guess what? He shut them both down. He's banned fracking on federal land.
Yeah. Gas
prices suddenly went from $1.70-something a gallon to $2.79 a gallon today.
Yeah.
And it's only been 3 months since he was inaugurated. Not even that.
No, it's not even two.
And guess what? Since Joe Biden's been elected,
days,
China's naval force has almost fucking doubled.
And people look at it and they go, well, you know, the liberals, well, you know, this is the carryover from Trump. It's just happened now.
Right, the borders carryover from Trump.
Oh, Joe Biden's rescuing the economy because of stuff that Trump put in place.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, the market didn't go down. That's amazing.
The market's been fucked up lately.
Well, that's
I watch the market. I have stocks. The market's fucked.
Yeah. Nobody trusts Biden. How can you? When he
apparently
signed the when he
the Chinese do.
Well, they trust him to betray us.
You guys are aware that the Chinese naval force has almost doubled since his inauguration.
Oh, Biden's? They plan on taking over on us, and it's going to be doing them through Biden.
They're moving. Chinese are moving forces, naval forces especially, towards Taiwan.
Yep.
And Joe Biden is fucking silent.
And they're fucking with India, too.
The media, nobody's questioning anything he does.
I'll tell you what, the wrong country, is India.
The wrong country to fuck with is India and Russia together.
Yeah. Oh, check this out.
Putin. This is why everybody wants to say Russia's the enemy. Russia's the main global threat. Putin kicked the central banks out of Russia.
Yeah. You know what? Putin's a fucking a horrible human being, right? But he does want
horrible for what?
He's fucking throwing fucking innocent people into fucking gulags and
before he became the president, of course he did.
And he's poisoning orders people. Then.
Look, Putin's not a great guy. He's a horrible human being. But what he does want is what's best for the Russian people. And what's best,
and what's
for, the
best
Russian
for the Russian people.
People
is the same thing that Trump wants. Rid of the central
banks. It's Russia first.
Exactly.
But Russia first depends on America being healthy.
Right. They hit coattails.
I was watching this thing, right?
Notice that all of the countries that are bitching and threatening the U.S. since Biden was inaugurated are the ones that Trump made peace with.
Yeah, well, I seen a thing on YouTube about supposedly Russia and China are going to do a fucking cooperative space program to put people permanently on the moon, like a moon base, right?
Not going to happen.
Yeah, and I was like, what the fuck? Then I went into the comments, and it was all Russian people and shit going, never going to happen. Never gonna
Russia
happen.
Will never ever cooperate.
I'd like to know their
with
history.
Anything regarding China.
They hate the Chinese.
Unless it's to achieve a narrative.
What do you mean? What kind of a
like
narrative?
The Chinese. No. If the narrative if a narrative results in supporting the Chinese and it benefits Russia, Russia will support them. Same way with the U.S. If it benefits the U.S. to support China, they will support China.
Yeah.
It's all about the billionaire elites and everything else.
Yeah.
I know Russia can't stand China, but if they were to benefit from it, things would change.
Well, and the thing is, Biden's not fucking helping.
No, he's not. He's in the Chinese pocket.
Yeah, why he's pushing the Russians away from us.
Whatever happened to Hunter Biden? This guy never even had a fucking pre-trial conference.
Why do you think Biden is not making any kind of threats or acting in any way serious towards China and their and the way they're treating Taiwan?
Because
in their fucking pockets.
Exactly. He's receiving same thing with Disney. Fucking Disney fucking filmed Mulan right next to a fucking basically a concentration camp.
Oh yeah.
Right? And then at the end of the movie, thank China for all they had done.
I thought it was a cartoon.
No, they made a live action version. Hear that?
Yes, they did.
Thanking the Chinese for their Star Wars posters, for the sequel, the character Finn, who's a black guy, right? He was real prominent in the poster in the United States, Europe, Japan, stuff, right? For the Chinese fucking version, they shrunk him down and put them way in the background. Because Chinese people don't like black people. They don't like the fucking home skillets.
I'll tell you what. The guy that played Finn in the Star Wars movies will never act again.
Yeah, because he shit on fucking Star Wars.
No. Because he shit on Disney. Listen to the podcast that he does daily on iHeartRadio.
Yeah, I know. When
he's
I
much
said
more
Star
conservative
Wars,
than they will admit, they're trying to keep it covered up. They don't like him. They don't like Adam Driver either.
You no,
never
because
see
he's
Adam
a
Driver in another Star Wars film of any kind.
Yep.
As a matter of fact, it'll be a miracle if he ever acts again.
He was a Marine.
Well, yeah, he was the only one at the Academy Awards fucking laughing his ass off at Ricky Gervais. Golden Globes. So guess what? The only fucking person in the entire audience laughing was an Armed Forces veteran.
Yeah, yeah. And do you know what? I seen him on Saturday Night Live. I seen the clips. He was fucking funny as hell.
Who?
Adam Driver.
Yeah,
Undercover boss.
My name's Dave, and I'm a radar technician.
Yeah, he was doing Undercover Boss. Oh, it's fucking great.
He did two of those.
Yeah, he did two of them, exactly.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad show.
They fucking did an update.
You see Adam Driver, or what is it, John Boyega, the black guy, in any major Hollywood films again, ever.
Which is sad because, you know, at the two that fucking called Disney out, well, actually, it was only Boyega that called Disney out. I don't think Adam Driver ever did.
Adam Driver didn't actually call them out, but he laughed at them at the global.
You know, when fucking Gervais is calling them all perverts and stuff?
Perverts and pedophiles and everything else. Get up here and accept your fucking award and get off the stage.
Yeah, Harvey Weinstein. He's your friend, not mine. I didn't do this. And then he brought up fucking Epstein. Fucking great.
Make no mistake. Just about all your Hollywood elite are in this fucking pedophilia bullshit and everything else. That's why they all turned on Trump.
Do you see the look on Tom Hanks's face?
Yeah, he was livid.
He reacted.
You know, just within a few weeks after that, Tom Hanks and his wife went and
moved to fucking
obtained, what was it, Greek citizenship?
Yep.
So they could flee the country if they had to?
Yeah. Yep.
Because I guess pedophilia is fine in Greece.
What does that say about you?
It says Tom Hanks is a dirty motherfucker. Yep. He's a dirty motherfucker. He's a piece of shit. You know, and everyone goes,
he used to be one of my favorite actors until I started seeing shit like that happen.
Yeah, and everyone said, what are you, crazy? He's like, like an American icon. What was Bill Cosby?
Right.
He was America's dad. Where's he now?
Fuck, he was an icon of stand-up, television, movies, you name it.
Yeah.
And then he got fucking sent down the river. You know why? Because he probably turned on Hollywood.
No, they figured he's old, he's useless
now.
Yeah,
but that's definitely bag job.
No, they said, there's your fucking person. Now leave us alone. So
yeah,
we can go
somebody
back.
Had to be sacrificed.
Exactly. Somebody had to be on the altar. And it was Cosby. He didn't do anything worse than the rest of them. Fucking Weinstein's a fucking prime example. They were all praising him 6 months before it happened.
What was the one girl that played in Charmed, dated Marilyn Manson? She came out against Harvey Weinstein.
Oh my God.
Gela?
No.
No.
Oh my God.
Did you say Geller?
Yeah, Sarah something Geller.
Sarah Michelle Geller was Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Yeah, what was her name? Fuck! She had a real, she's got a real Irish
Rose name. McGowan.
Rose McGowan. Yeah.
Did you notice how anti-Trump she was before all the Weinstein shit went down?
Yeah, and you see
now
how
all of a sudden she's silent on Trump?
Right. And then going after the left.
Yep.
And she left Trump out of it, which was a smart move for her. Because she kept credibility on the left by not dragging Trump into it. You know what I mean? Because they would have said, oh, he's now she's just a Trump supporter. You know what I mean? And I'll give her credit. I'll give that girl credit. She's a lunatic. But she's right.
She was all for the Me Too movement and everything else until everything started coming to light about Weinstein and all this stuff. And then she's suddenly realizing that, wait a minute, the people that she's supporting are supporting Weinstein.
Yeah, she went after
her. She suffered under Weinstein.
And then the people she
supports started supporting Weinstein. And she's like, wait a minute, what the fuck? How can you?
And then she went after Alyssa Milano for the Me Too thing, and she's like, you hijacked the thing. You turned it into a manhunt. It's not about a manhunt. It's about bad men. Bad women, for that matter.
Imagine Tony Danza. How a wholesome kind of family-oriented kind of guy that he is, for one of his co-stars to come out and start doing all that shit. He's been completely quiet.
Yeah, shut your mouth. Nobody cares about your political opinions.
Alyssa Milano.
Yeah, Alyssa Milano. And she called her a fucking fake and a phony. She goes, you only care about the Me Too movement when it makes you money. When it gets you hit so you stay relevant.
Well, so did Ashley Judd. Guess where Ashley Judd's at now?
Yeah, nowhere. Yeah.
You haven't seen a movie from her in a while.
Yeah, do you know why? Because she really, really went too far. When she read that poem, nasty.
Oh, yeah.
It's like you're a lunatic.
And Madonna.
I'll be right back. Oh, yeah, that one too.
She was due to release a new album. What happened to that?
What, that same time when she went up and said she wanted to blow up the White House?
Yep. Not long after that, talk of her new album was dead.
Yeah, sales would have went down. Like I said, I don't know why these people come out like this. They disregard 50% of the population.
What's really sickening is it's a in large part conservative people that made them famous, and they just shit all over them. It was largely conservatives that made these musicians and these actors famous, and these people just shit all over the people that loved them.
Biting their fucking hand, the feet.
Bruce Springsteen, born in the USA, he's a fucking commie piece of shit.
Yeah, I know it.
How dare he fucking sing a song like that with the kind of stance that he has?
He was tight with the vets. Now I don't understand what he's doing.
He is nothing. He's a piece of
filth. He's always been a liberal piece of shit.
How can you sing Born in the USA while the Berlin Wall's coming down and then turn around and fucking support socialists and communists?
Right.
Dude, why? Because he won't have to live under them rules.
Bruce Springsteen.
Bruce Stinkstein.
When they turn this into a socialist country, you do know everybody's going to move to Canada or some other place where there's freedom.
No. Canada, there's freedom?
No, there's not.
No, there's not.
They might go to some place like, say, Sweden or Norway.
Or
that's a whole new language to learn.
Or you take the country back. From
you're
these
about
fucks.
What you guys are about to witness
with what,
mass shootings, and I mean mass shootings on a scale like to which we've never seen. And you know why? Because they're pushing gun control. And the only way, even with 50-50 in the Senate and Kamala Harris the deciding vote, the only way they're going to pass that, even by the Democrats, is mass shootings.
Oh, I know what you're saying. Yeah. They'll stage more. They'll have more of their fucking automatons fucking going
the
and doing.
The riots, the mass shootings, the protests, all of that shit is about to increase as soon as they realize that their legislation is not going to pass without it.
Yep. I totally agree with that. But the thing is, right? Americans aren't going to give up their guns like Aussies did or fucking the English did.
You're not going to have 300-some million guns in the possession of 82 million people and expect them to turn them in.
It's not going to happen. They'll say no.
No, but they'll do it one at a time. They've been doing this slowly now because back in the 60s, there was never this many felonies.
I can
they
tell
make
you,
everything a felony.
They
that's
redefined
their way
everything. They literally redefined everything to make it fit the law.
Yep. To make it, they want everyone
domestic violence. Granted, domestic violence is one of the most appalling things I could possibly think of next to fucking murdering a child. They redefined it so it would constitute a felony or a crime to where you could not own
a gun. Right. They're doing it with everything.
They're making everything a felony.
1964 Gun Control Act. Look it up. They redefine it so that anyone who's committed a felony domestic violence cannot own firearms.
Yeah, you can't even have them in your house. You know, that's ridiculous.
If you can't do away with the Second Amendment, change the laws to circumvent it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Domestic violence was never considered a felony back then. They were considered assaults, whether who hit
it was
who.
Considered well, a violent crime.
Assault, not a felony.
It was considered a violent crime, which made it
not back in the 60s.
To deny
not back in the 60s.
Yes,
you're
this,
talking
yes,
now.
It was 1964 Gun Control Act. Look it up.
What's that got to do with
domestic
what we're talking
violence
about?
Was considered a violent crime by which they could deny your Second Amendment rights.
Yes.
The Second Amendment, nowhere in that does it say
if you're a felon, you can't own a gun.
You the right to bear arms, even if it's a felony.
It says infringed.
Do not infringe. Cannot be infringed. The right of the people to bear and keep and bear arms cannot be infringed, or must not be infringed, whatever it says.
Will not be infringed.
That includes felons.
Yeah, a felon after he served his term and paid his debt to society.
Right. To forever ban him for having a gun.
He cannot own a firearm, but he can sure fucking vote for the Democrat that sends him money, right?
Yep. And even if you want to infringe it slightly, yeah, you might not be able to carry, but you should be able to have one in your house to protect yourself.
They're plugging away at the Second Amendment a little bit at a time. Just like the freedom of speech, they can say, oh, this offends me, or that offends me, or this offends me, or whatever. Yes, and pretty soon, it's publicly acceptable to not say something, but the freedom of speech is still in place.
Well, it's like
they do it without, they circumvent the freedom of speech, the Second Amendment, they circumvented all by creating situations that are publicly acceptable. Hence mass shootings. Hence, oh my God, Pepe Le Pew offends me.
Yep, Speedy Gonzalez.
Yeah.
It's all about circumventing the Constitution without actually creating any new laws.
Yep. It's about feelings. It's not about facts. That's for sure.
And if we're a land of...
Do you think you would have seen any of this shit before Obama? Fuck no.
No. If we were a law-abiding country, we wouldn't be fucking lost it.
Look, the state of Ohio alone, and this is just the state of Ohio. Obama bailed out the auto industry, right?
Yep.
You know what he did in order to do that? And this is just one city. City of Kettering, Ohio. Delphi employees. He told GM that they could take the retirement of over 20,000 retired Delphi employees in order to pay back their debt to the government.
Wow.
20,000.
Wow.
Ohio Delphi employees lost their retirement over the auto industry bailout.
That's disgusting. And do you know what?
Nobody's talking about it. Obama's a fucking hero, right?
Yeah, but it's kind of their fault, too. Because the unions made these deals, right? I mean...
Well, you're exactly right. Nobody fought it.
Because
those people who didn't fight it were getting money shoved in their fucking pockets left and right.
And you ever notice liberals always talk about sustainability? Right. Sustainability, yeah, right? But when
UN Agenda 21, sustainability.
When unions make these fucking deals with companies that they know the company could never ever fulfill. Yeah,
unsustainable.
It's unsustainable. But that's
different. Why do you think unions like the UAW do what they do?
Because they want to cling to power. They want to be able to influential
they
in the
cling to power. They can make money while killing jobs at the same time. Don't care if their union employees lose their jobs as long as they have cash coming in.
Yep.
If you get laid off, as a union employee, you still have to pay union dues. The union's still fucking making money.
Yep.
Even if you're not working.
It could be years waiting.
And what happens a couple, two or three, four, maybe 5 or 6 months down the road, if you're still laid off and you can't pay union dues, you're kicked out of the union and your job's no longer protected.
You're never going to go back. Hell so they're no. making you pay for something on a false hope.
It's like paying for that fucking 2-year warranty at Walmart on a piece of electronics you just bought.
Yeah. It's like, you know, these fucking things are only going to last a couple years. You buy, and they want, do you want the warranty? No, I'm going to be throwing it away in a year and a half and buying a better one.
Why do you think Jimmy Hoffa disappeared?
Jeez, Hoffa, I'll give you like 10 reasons.
Even well, besides the illegal bullshit, Jimmy Hoffa was actually on the side of the worker for the most part. And the elite could not afford that to happen. So he had to go. That not only that, because he was gaining too much popularity and control.
Jimmy Hoffa was a piece of shit.
Well, yes, of course.
I'll tell you one thing. Do you know what signed his death warrant was when he stood up to fucking Bobby Kennedy and told, he's like, you're the son of a bootlegger. Who are you to tell me? That's what, in the congressional hearings, that's what signed his death warrant.
Well, yeah.
Jimmy Hoffa was a piece of shit. And he wasn't for anybody but himself.
But the Kennedys are elitists.
They're bigger pieces of shit. But if you tell me Jimmy Hoffa...
The only Kennedy that wasn't an elitist... Well, actually, I should take that back. There was like maybe two of them that weren't elitists. And that was John F. Kennedy.
Okay.
And John F. Kennedy Jr.
John F. Kennedy Jr., I'll give you. John F. Kennedy was an elitist. He took advantage of everything. Really? He
went against the Democratic liberals and was assassinated for it.
There was more to it than that, but...
Well, yes, of course, there was the mob involved and yada, yada, yada.
I'll tell you why John Kennedy got assassinated. Because the mob got him fucking in office, right? And then he turned on him. Hired his younger brother Johnny as Attorney General, and they went after the fucking hand that they bit the hand that fed them. Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
And to see Think Jimmy Hoffa, and to see Jimmy Hoffa kid about anyone but himself.
No. It's
he wasn't for the work.
I don't want to diss Donald Trump. Because I think what he did was a great fucking thing. But Donald Trump never does anything without his money in mind.
Oh, did what?
If it benefits the American people while putting money in his pocket, he will do it.
That's
fine. If
he
does not put money in his pocket, he won't do it.
Do you think if it benefited the American people in a tangible sense, and it didn't put money in his pocket, you don't think he'd do it?
No, I don't.
I think you're wrong.
No, I don't. That's one of the reasons why the Chinese are in the shape they're in now. He did away with all of this bullshit dealing with the Chinese, so American Steel, which American Steel, by the way, would have fattened his wallet.
He lost money Donald being Trump president.
And what he did for the American people was great. But there's still the fact that what he did would have ultimately, in the end, even after 8 years, would have benefited his wallet. It would have made his business boom.
His company
used American Steel. And in order to be able to compete, Chinese steel had to go down. Guess what happened when Trump went into office?
But still, it would have been good for the American people. He's an American citizen. Why shouldn't he benefit from it too?
I am not downing him or faulting him for that. But what I'm saying is he did this with his wallet in mind.
Well, even if he did...
Donald Trump is a great American, and I love him to death, and I swear to God, I hope to God he becomes president in 2024.
Yeah.
It's a benefit to him.
Guess what? It should be a benefit to him
to make billions of dollars by regulating Chinese steel out of the market. Would you do it?
Yes.
Of course. Okay, then you have Donald Trump. Thank you.
That's fine. He's an American citizen. Why shouldn't he benefit from America doing better?
Exactly my point. The liberal left and the Democrats are trying to portray this out as he did this. He's a criminal. He's this. He did it to, well, yeah, he did it to benefit himself, but he also did it to benefit the American people. Benefiting an American people, benefiting himself, it worked out to the same end.
Joe Biden wasn't.
The end justified the means.
Joe Biden wasn't looking out for the American people.
He would benefit by helping the American people rather than going against them.
And so wouldn't everyone else on Wall Street.
What they don't understand is you got Rudy Giuliani, you got Donald Trump, you got what's her name, the fucking military attorney, all claiming election fraud and everything else. Do you know back in the 80s and 90s, Donald Trump included, were what helped take the mob down?
Yeah. I wouldn't doubt it. Because you know informants. Trump didn't want to deal with the fucking
Giuliani. Giuliani and that one lady were the attorneys, and Trump was the informant.
Yeah. And not to mention, right? Why would you
Trump had to deal with all of the mafia families during his construction days?
Exactly.
He had every little tidbit of information they could possibly imagine on the mob.
Yeah, and the mob.
What do you think Giuliani supports him?
Jeremy, can you give me a sec? He's dealing with the mob, right? And they're selling him an inferior product. He knows it's inferior, but yet he has to deal with them. Because of the unions.
Yep.
Of course he's pissed.
Why do you think Giuliani still supports him? Because Trump helped take out the mob.
Yeah, and it made New York a better place. Look what happened at Times Square. Times Square, before Giuliani, was nothing but strip joints, peep shows.
That. I went there.
It was disgusting.
What do you think?
And then when he got into office, look at Times Square now.
Right.
What do you think would happen if the Democrats and the liberals were taken out because of the crimes that they committed against the American people?
There'd be a lot of ropes.
Who's going to benefit by taking these guys out? These guys are nothing different than the mob. Who would benefit by taking out the liberals?
The people.
Yeah. And politician-wise.
Trump. Trump.
Giuliani.
Giuliani. Anyone that's on that side. Anyone that's
everything you see going on right now. I'm not saying this is going to happen. But this is what it looks like, the same shit they did when they were taking down the mob. Letting them commit crimes, letting the American people see it, and then taking them out.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. You got to let the American people see it. So they can say, how is this happening?
It's going to take something bigger than what happened to the mob for this to work.
I mean, before Giuliani became...
You're going to need a major crisis, whether it be mass shootings all over the place or an economic crisis, for this to work. That's why you see all these QAnon conspiracy theories about it out there. This is why I don't believe them. Because it will take something drastically different than what happened to the mob for their theories to work.
Well, there's a pattern. Things go in patterns.
Mm-hmm.
Shit hits a fan. Somebody jumps in and says, hey, we got to fix this. It gets fixed, usually by a Republican. And then people get comfortable with it, right? And then they go, well, we'll just vote for a Democrat. And then it goes back into the shit again.
It keeps going back and forth until the laws get changed to the way they want them.
Yeah.
They have the American people, mass shootings, oh my God, gun control, we need gun control so they can stop killing our babies. Guess what? Criminals don't obey gun laws.
Exactly. And the vast majority of people understand that. They really do.
The government thinks we're stupid.
Well, they are being dumbed down a lot.
You remember Halloween 2, the movie Halloween 2, where they had the mask, and every time they fucking turned on the TV, the mask would activate and fucking start killing people?
Never seen the movie.
I've seen it, but I don't know nothing about it. There was like 13 of them.
It is literally a fantasy version of what is happening today. You see one thing, and the media and the government portrays it as another, i.e. the mask. And then as soon as you turn on the channel, bam, you're indoctrinated. You get it?
Oh, yeah.
And every single day, you get all these American people, including you, me, everybody who even supports Trump, turning on that little device that puts out a 44 hertz signal. 44 hertz, believe it or not, has scientifically been proven to interrupt brain waves and slow them down.
Woo!
Why do you think all your television broadcasts, your news broadcasts, your TV shows, why do you think all of that is broadcast in 44 hertz?
What is?
Did you... Damn it, Jim, I'm going to give you a boo. You better watch it. Everything you watch, nobody even suspects this. Like, oh my God, I got a Sony Bravia, blah, 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 blah. It's the best TV in the world. It's broadcasting at 44 hertz. What does 44 hertz do? It slows down your brainwaves.
When you slow down your brainwaves,
you don't think as quickly, you don't think as clearly, as positively.
I haven't.
There is actually scientific research to back that. Well, stop watching TV.
Yeah, I know it. I swear to God.
Literally,
I'm a zombie when I'm in front of one or a computer.
If you're going to watch TV, watch it on a 165 hertz computer monitor.
I watch it on the computer.
The computer monitor that you have is 60 hertz at a maximum.
I don't know.
Which will automatically dumb down the signal to 44 hertz on a national television broadcast. Like my monitor is 165, so it will only default down to 148 hertz, I think, or 144 hertz instead of 44 hertz. So whenever I watch TV, it's on my computer monitor. The lowest it will refresh at is 144 hertz.
Is that because of the cable?
Because of the monitor.
Oh, it's the monitor.
Yes. You change your TV to, say, a 27-inch computer monitor and start watching your TV over the computer instead of the TV.
Yeah, everything I watch changes. On TV now is on the computer. Yep, I got Pluto and Tubby.
Your current computer monitor probably has a maximum broadcast range of about 90 hertz at a max, which means it will still automatically dumb down whatever signal you're receiving to 44 hertz.
You're putting Paul to sleep.
No, I'm fine.
And the only thing that isn't affected by that is, like, say, your video games.
Which I don't play anymore. I haven't played in over a decade.
Now, like I was saying earlier, if you take, like, say, my monitor, which is set to 165 hertz, it will only dumb down to 144 hertz. A TV broadcast signal is 44 hertz, 100 hertz less than what my minimum broadcast signal on my monitor is.
Well, you know what it sounds like to me, Jim?
What's that?
Everything hurts.
Exactly. Oh, my God.
Play the song! Play the song!
Paul Daniels wises up.
Actually, I want to make a drink and take a piss, so...
You know how they have... like PlayStations and Blu-ray players and everything else now that will upscale things to 4K. That's okay. The same way my monitor works. You send a 44 hertz signal to my monitor and it upscales it to 144.
Yeah, we don't even know what the fuck you're talking about.
It's right, Jimmy? It's the same thing as a radio wave. Think about radio waves.
Right. Think about
a radio
about
wave coming in at 60 clicks per second.
All right, yeah.
You know, I went to school the radio as an electronic engineer, and this all goes way back.
Boo, hiss, boo. Oh, anyway, you get a radio wave coming in at, say, 60 hertz, but the equipment you use, or the broadcast signal's at 44 hertz for the radio. That wave, and you're using a radio that's say 60 hertz maximum. That radio will dumb it down to 44.
Okay.
All right.
You know how uninterested we are?
The faster the wave comes in, the slower it comes out. If you take a 60 hertz radio, you could put a 150 hertz signal into that radio, it's still only going to come out at 60 hertz.
Oh.
It dumbs it down.
Okay. Trust you. Right, Jim? You trust him.
We're being fucked right before our very eyes, and we don't even know it.
Right. Well, my 5G has been killing me for the last 6 months.
All right, I think we're out of here, folks.
But it's okay. No, we're not.
I'm at 850.
We are not out of here without a salute to the troops.
Thank you, Jeremy.
All right. Now we can go. We'll catch you, folks.
No, go ahead.
I would love to send out a shout out to the troops at home and abroad, our first responders, our police, and yes, even our FBI. Stay vigilant. Don't trust the government. Be safe.
Thank you, Jeremy. I'd like to say for everyone, good night. See you next week. Same time, same channel. Peace out, nigga.
Good night.
Tell me how.